गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वी आर दिस लेक्चर नंबर 15 फॉर एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज। टुडे इज 1 मई 2021। तो लेक्चर टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ बायोडायवर्सिटी objects and the various laws. In previous lectures also we have seen in 13 that the conservation of the biodiversity is having two types, and we'll see in detail today this in situ conservation and the ex situ conservation. So in in-situ conservation, the conservation through our national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, sacred groves, and the biosphere reserves. So these are different we are making to conserve the species of plant and animals, etc. They are in danger or they are on the verge of extinct. Okay, so this in situ conservation, or it is also site on site conservation. Second one, the ex situ conservation, and it is called as off site conservation. Means the we are conserving the animal and plant etc. at the another place of their other than their natural habitat. So they are called as the ex situ conservations. So conservation of biodiversity in ex situ conservation, it is the botanical gardens, zoological park, seed banks, gene banks, etc. So they are coming into the ex situ conservation or off site conservation of your biodiversity. So biodiversity conservation, why it is necessary? Because due to the human activity, many species on the earth, they are extinct. Extinction, they are on the verge of destroying or their no more this species will be available to us in future. So the hope for conservation of nature biodiversity rests on preservation of selected ecosystem and representative areas of different vegetation types in the country, as well as on saving some of the extinct form species. So the species एकदम से खत्म हो रहे हैं, तो उनको सेव करना इज नथिंग बट द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ द बायोडाइवर्सिटी। तो बायोडाइवर्सिटी आपको मालूम, बायो मीन्स अ लाइफ एंड डाइवर्सिटी इन द वैरायटी। तो डिफरेंट वैरायटी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड प्लांट्स आर देयर ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ अर्थ। तो दीज वैरायटीज आर वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर मेंटेनिंग द इकोलॉजिकल साइकिल। So that's why the conservation of biodiversity means conservation of these species. They are very few available at very few places. The number of endangered species means the species, they are reducing, their population are reducing day by day. Of plant, animal is on the rise. So they are in danger, the species, if they are reducing, so they are in danger, and which has prompted government and non-government organization and non-government, inko NGOs bolte hain, non-government organization, to take certain steps to avoid this further reduction in population of this endangered species. तो पहले से जो स्पेसीज जो जिनकी पॉपुलेशन कम हो रही है उनको बचाने के लिए गवर्नमेंट और नॉन गवर्नमेंट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन काम कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज दे आर ऑल्सो यूजफुल टू मेंटेन अवर इकोलॉजिकल सर्कल, नाइदर वी नॉर दे, यानी ऑल ऑफ अस दे आर वेरी यूजफुल फॉर टू मेंटेन द इकोलॉजिकल साइकिल. सो दैट्स वाई द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ दिस इनडेंजर स्पेसीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इन दिस डायरेक्शन फॉरेस्ट्री एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ वे आर प्राइमरीली अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट, बट लेटर ऑन लुकिंग टू द ग्रेविटी ऑफ द सिचुएशन अ सेपरेट मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इन्वायरमेंट एंड फॉरेस्ट वॉज इस्टेब्लिश. ओके, टू लुक टू द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ दिस टू सेव द इनडेंजर स्पेसीज, देन द गवर्नमेंट आर एक्टेड एंड दे आर prepared, separated the separate ministry for the environment and forest, and they are working continuously on the conservation of this biodiversity. And how we will see one by one. Is tarah wo kaam kar raha. The aims and objective of wildlife management in India include the following. The objective and the aims to conserve or management of the wildlife, these are the objectives in India. First was the protection of the natural habitat. Second, maintain of a viable number of species. Establishment of biosphere reserves, any ऐसी जगह जहाँ पर ये स्पेसीज को सर्वाइवल की जगह रहे, तो इसको हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं, बायोस्फीयर, बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स. एंड प्रोटेक्शन थ्रू लेजिस्लेशन, यानी लॉ और कानून बनाकर उसकी उसकी वजह से हम वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट दिस स्पेसीज. तो वी आर वर्किंग द ऑब्जेक्टिव और द वाइल्ड लाइफ मैनेजमेंट आर इन इंडिया कैटेगरीज. The laws governing biodiversity conservation in India, the different laws, we can say the Madras Wild Elephant Preservation Act in 1873, then All India Elephant Preservation Act in 1879, the Indian Fisheries Act 1897. So all these acts are made to control the biodiversity. Okay. The student joining late, they are disturbing the class. The Wild Birds and Wild Animals Protection Act in 1912. Then the Indian Forest Act in 1927, Bengal Rhinoceros Act in 1932, Himalayan National Park Act in 1936, Bombay Wild Animals and Wild Birds Protection Act 1951, Assam Rhinoceros Protection Act 1954, Cruelty Against Animals Act 1960, the Wildlife Protection Act in 1972, the Forest Conservation Act 1980, and Wildlife Protection Amendment Act at 1991, then Conservation of Forest and National Ecosystem Act in 1994. So these are different laws and acts are released by the government of India to reserve or to save the species they are going to be extinct. Okay, going to be extinct, yani they are going to be vanished, they will no more available or seen in the land, as that we are talking about the dinosaur. Now you can see the biodiversity conservation, in situ and ex situ conservation of biodiversity. दो टाइप की डाइवर्सिटी हम लोग ने पढ़ा, नीचे डिफरेंशिएट है, वी विल गो वन बाय वन. द गोल ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी कंजर्वेशन कैन बी अटेन्ड इन अ नंबर ऑफ वेज. द कंसेप्ट ऑफ जीन बैंक रेगुलेट ऑल दीज मेथड्स. तो जीन बैंक यानी ऐसे स्पेसीज जिनकी जो रिडक्शन, पॉपुलेशन रिडक्शन हो रहा है तेजी से, उनके जीन्स को हम स्टोर करें और ऐसे प्लेसेस हम बनाए कि वी कैन मेक एंड दे कैन फ्लरिश एंड देयर पॉपुलेशन विल बी इंक्रीज. तो दीज आर द वर्किंग नाउडेज ऑन द सिचुएशन. इट इज रिडक्शन ऑफ स्पेसीज. तो इन सिटू कंजर्वेशन means it can be defined as the conservation of plants and animals in their native ecosystem. यानी जहाँ पर वो, जहाँ उनकी पैदाइश हुई है, जहाँ के वो चरिन परिंद है, जो हैबिटेट में वो जी रहे हैं, वहीं पर उनको कंजर्व किया जाए. तो उनको हम क्या बोलते हैं, इन सिटू कंजर्वेशन. तो नेचुरल हैबिटेट्स उनका जो है, जहाँ के वो है, जहाँ के उनकी पैदाइश है, जो हैबिटेट में अभी तक वो रहते आए हैं, तो उनको क्या बोलते हैं हम लोग, नेटिव स्पेसिस. और उनको वहीं पर हम लोग अगर कंजर्व करें, प्रोटेक्ट करें, तो वो क्या कहलाता है, वो कहलाता है इन सिटू कंजर्वेशन ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी. और इवन मैन मेड इकोसिस्टम, या अगर हम कुछ ऐसा इकोसिस्टम हम लोग बनाते हैं, कोई जगह हम इसे फिक्स करते हैं, और देन वी आर प्रोटेक्टिंग देयर, एंड दैट इज कॉल्ड एज मैन मेड इकोसिस्टम. ओके, तो हियर इन रेड रेड रिमार्क, दीज आर द वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज इन इंडिया, एंड देन यू कैन सी द ब्लू सर्कल और ग्रीन सर्कल, दे आर द बर्ड सेंचुरीज and national park with the triangle, blue triangle. You can see here the Gir National Park, Sanjay Gandhi National Park, hai na? Then Bandarpur National Park, over there Ranthambore, then Ikalapuram, then you can see different National Park, wildlife sanctuaries are there, wildlife sanctuaries in the different part of the country. You can see with this red and this green circle, you know, is the bird sanctuaries. In Maharashtra also, if you are going to the Panvel to the their Kokan side, you can see that the Karnala bird sanctuary is there. So different bird sanctuaries, wildlife sanctuaries, and national park, and why these are governments are developed, because to save the species, they are reducing their population and disease. So their conservation, for that we are maintaining this. This type of conservation is applicable to wild flora and fauna, as a conservation is achieved through production of population in their natural ecosystem. तो उनके natural ecosystem में अगर हम conservation करते हैं, तो उनको क्या बोला जाता है, उनको बोला जाता है in situ conservation of biodiversity. तो इसके लिए the concept of protect areas falls under the category of national park. National parks हैं, संजय गांधी नेशनल पार्क है हमारे मुंबई में, बर्ड सेंचुरीज है, मैंने जैसे बताया कि कर्नाला बर्ड सेंचुरीज है, कोकण के साइड में हम जाते हैं, और बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स. बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स मीन्स हम ऐसी जगह, ऐसे लैंड डेवलप करते हैं कि उनको वो माहौल दे जो उनको नेटिव हैबिटेट में उनको मिलता है, तो उसको हम क्या बोलते हैं, जो रवि द बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स. And they are the areas of terrestrial and coastal ecosystem, promoting solution to reconcile the conservation of biodiversity with its sustainable use. They are internationally recognized, nominated by national governments, and remain under सोरियन जरिडिक्शन ऑफ स्टेट्स वेयर दे आर लोकेटेड। तो ये बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स, जैसे कि हम लोग नेशनल पार्क बनाते हैं, जैसे हम वर्ल्ड सेंचुरीज अलग कर देते हैं, तो इसी तरह बायोस्फीयर रिजर्व्स वी आर मेकिंग टू सर्वाइव और टू प्रोटेक्ट द आवर बायोडाइवर्सिटी। नाउ वी कैन कम टू द एक्स सिटू कन्वर्जेशन। अभी तक हम लोग डिटेल में नहीं पढ़े थे, वी आर स्टडिंग इन डिटेल व्हाट इज द इन सिटू एंड व्हाट द एक्स सिटू। इट कैन बी डिफाइंड एज द कंजर्वेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स अवे फ्रॉम देयर नेचुरल हैबिटेट। तो कंजर्वेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स अवे फ्रॉम देयर नेचुरल हैबिटेट, वो कहीं और के जानदार हैं और हम कहीं और उनके जीन्स और ये लेके हम अगर पॉपुलेशन उनको इंक्रीज करते हैं, उनको सेव करते हैं, उनके नेचुरल हैबिटेट से हट कर हम उनको वैसा हैबिटेट प्रोवाइड करते हैं, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्स सिटू कंजर्वेशन। ओके, तो इट इंक्लूड द कलेक्शन ऑफ सैंपल ऑफ जेनेटिक डाइवर्सिटी एंड देयर ट्रीटमेंट इन द लेबोरेटरी वेयर दे आर कल्चर्ड। तो ठीक है, तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं, सैंपल ऑफ जीन्स से हम लोग इसके इनके ट्रीटमेंट करते हैं और उनको कल्चर करते हैं, एंड देन वी आर डूइंग द ब्रीडिंग ऑफ दैट एनिमल्स और द प्लांट। द कंसेप्ट ऑफ जीन बैंक है ना, ऐसे इनके जीन बैंक और प्राइमरी बिकम द टॉक फॉर द एक्स सिटू कंजर्वेशन एज इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर क्रॉप्स एंड फॉरेस्ट्री बेस्ड एफोरेस्टेशन प्रोग्राम एक्सेट्रा। तो ये दीज आर द कंसेप्ट, वी आर कलेक्टिंग द जीन्स एंड एज पर द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ एरिया वी कैन कल्टिवेट अवर लैंड्स एंड देन वी कैन प्रोड्यूस द सीड्स एंड द फॉर द इंक्रीजिंग ऑफ दैट पॉपुलेशन। देन जेनेटिक रिसोर्सेज सेंटर्स फॉल्स अंडर द कैटेगरी and include the botanical gardens, zoological park, seed banks, gene banks. All these are category of the ex situ conservation of your biodiversity. So nowadays it is very common, you can see the seed banks, seed of plants are produced at the factories and they are giving the good result when they are cultivated. Isi tarah gene banks animals ke जीन्स को कलेक्ट कर हम उसको स्टोर करते हैं, तो दे आर कमिंग टू द जीन बैंक। ऑल्सो द जियोलॉजिकल पार्क एंड द बॉटनिकल गार्डन वेयर वी आर कंजर्विंग दिस एनिमल्स एंड अदर देन देयर नेचुरल हैबिटेट्स, तो दे आर कमिंग अंडर द एक्स सिटू कंजर्वेशन ऑफ द बायोडाइवर्सिटी। ओके, नाउ विल सी हियर the distribution between national park, sanctuary and biosphere reserve for in-situ conservation. So, yahan par in-situ conservation mein, jaise ki hum log ne aage dekha tha, they are national park, hai na? Aur sanctuaries and the biospaces. So, what are they different, you can see, in terms of associated with them. So we can see the associated to the habitat of wild animal species like rhinoceros, tiger, lion, etc. It is coming into the national park. It's coming into the national park. And sanctuaries, these are the species oriented as the pitcher plant, Indian bustard. Okay. So and the biosphere reserves takes into consideration the entire ecosystem. So biosphere reserves is considered for the entire ecosystem. National park generally the animal species they are reducing day by day, such as rhinos and tigers and lions, and we are putting into the national park and we are reserving them and we are protecting them. The size range of the national park is from 0.04 square kilometer to the 3162 square kilometer. The size of sanctuaries ranges from 0.61 square kilometer to the 7818 square kilometer. but the size of biosphere reserve is much larger than this national park. They are around 5,670 square kilometers. So there are different zones and different types of how we can conserve the biodiversity at the in-situ conservation. Boundaries marked by the legislation, disturbances only limited to buffer zone. So there are different zones we are creating, and only that zone are allowed to be for the human beings. Boundaries not available, anyone can go and watch. Boundaries marked by legislation in the biosphere reserve also. And untold distribution only limited to the buffer zone. There are different zones we are making for the biosphere reserves. When you come to here, you will see. So, if you type biosphere reserves, you can see how the in India, many areas are biosphere reserves where the humans are not allowed and these species are reserved. So biosphere reserves, agar hum dekhenge, so this to provide a natural habitat to the different. So you can see here, it is visible, I think so. The buffer zone, core zone of 50 kilometer radius, and then again 50 kilometer is the buffer zone. So area where vultures and breeding is natural habitats, and around that the buffer zone where 50 to 100 kilometer where no the core zone where no human activity can be performed. And in buffer zone only the educationalist or the student and researchers we are going to there. So this is nothing but you can understand the biosphere reserve. The biosphere reserves, you can see here also the core zone, then buffer zone, then the transition zone, then the human settlement. So this way we can reserve our biodiversity of so you can see here also, and tourism, recreation, education, their reach, and R is the research, and the darker green area is the core area, and you can see green dots. This the biosphere reserve, hai na? This R1 is the for research workers, and that is the core area of the habitat, and the green you can see is the buffer area, and in the buffer area only educational and training and tourism at some section are provided, and the outer one is the you can see transition area for the tourism and recreation. So all these things are you can see for the biosphere reserves it is divided. So like a bird sanctuary and like a national park, it is the biosphere reserve, but there are different zones distribution and limited for the buffer zone. Then scientist management is lacking. Tourism is allowed in the sanctuaries, and national park is also in tourism allowed, but in biosphere reserve tourism generally not allowed. In biosphere reserve tourism is generally not allowed in the core zone. Okay, in the buffer zone it may be allowed in biosphere, but in the core zone the tourism is not allowed. So these are the differences, and then we can see the scientific management is lacking in the national park. Scientific management is lacking in the bird sanctuaries also, and scientific management is there in the biosphere reserve. So that is the important of the biosphere reserve to protect the our biodiversity or conservation of biodiversity. Then no attention is paid to gene pool conservation in the national park. In sanctuaries also no attention is paid to the gene pool conservation, but in biosphere reserve the attention is given to the gene pool conservation. Okay, so this is the difference between the national parks, sanctuaries and the biosphere reserve. Can you move forward? The national park, according to the Indian Board of Wildlife, IBWL, Indian Board of Wildlife, IBWL, a national park is an area dedicated by state for all time to conserve the scenery, natural and historical objects, conserve the wildlife therein and provide the enjoyment of the same in a such manner and such means that will leave them unimpaired for the enjoyment of the future generation with such modification as the local condition may demand. So national park we are preparing, and this is the according to the IBWL the definition of national park. The history of national park in India begins in 1936 when the Haile, now it is Corbett National Park of United Provinces, Uttar Pradesh, was created. Then the area is declared for the protection and preservation for all time of wildlife animals and wild vegetation for the benefit and advantage and enjoyment of the general public. In this area, hunting of fauna or collection of flora is prohibited except under the direction of park authority. Only they will allow. And there are 104 existing national park in India, 104 national park in India, covering area of around 40,501 square kilometer, which is 1.23% of the geographical area of the country. So it is very large area we are covering internationally. Okay, in the India. Then the sanctuaries, in the Indian Board for Wildlife has here also IBWL has defined a sanctuary as an area where killing, hunting, shooting, capturing of any species of bird or animal is prohibited. So bird sanctuaries or sanctuaries where the animals are living, in that area, killing, hunting and shooting or capturing of any species of birds are not allowed. Under control of highest authority in the department responsible for the management of sanctuaries and whose boundaries and characters should be sacrosanct as far as possible. By June 1992, India had 416 sanctuaries. The board has further clarified the position by stating that while the management of sanctuaries does not involve suspension or restriction of normal forest operation, it is desirable to assign a completely sacrosanct area with the sanctuaries to be known as Abhyaranya. Okay, it has also indicated the sanctuaries should be made accessible to public. So generally you can invite bird sanctuaries or animal sanctuaries, you can see the birds, animals, but there are the restriction of killing, hunting and shooting or capturing of these species. We cannot do this work. You can just go and enjoy the sanctuary. You can see the bird by your camera and telescopes, etc. You can enjoy the sightseeing of the centuries. But you cannot disturb them. The wildlife sanctuaries in India are classified as IUCN category IV protected areas between 1936 and 2016. 543 wildlife sanctuaries were established in country that cover around 45,914 square mile, or 1,018,918 square kilometer in 2017. Then different important wildlife reserves sanctuaries in India. Andhra Pradesh mein Kawal hai, Punjrama hai, Anilapattu hai. Arunachal Pradesh mein Naimitapa hai, Assam mein Kaziranga hai, Manas hai, Bihar mein Hazari Bar hai, Delta hai, Goa mein Mulen hai, Gujarat mein Gir hai, Wild Ash hai, Nal Sarovar hai, Haryana mein Sultanpur Lake hai, हिमाचल प्रदेश में गोविंद सागर है, जम्मू कश्मीर में चिंगम है, कर्नाटका में. सो दीज आर डिफरेंट वाइल्ड लाइफ रिजर्व इन डिफरेंट स्टेट्स. ऑल्सो वाइल्ड लाइफ रिजर्व इन महाराष्ट्र, पेंच है, नवेगांव है, ढकाना कोलकाज है, मणिपुर में केबुल है, एंड पंजाब में अबोहर है. These are the wildlife reserves and they are the natural habitats are providing to the species, and the conservation of these species are done, and that is called as biodiversity conservation. Biosphere reserves, iske taluk se hum log ne padha, the core area. No human interference is there in the core area. Buffer zone, researchers and the educational are allowed in the buffer zone and in the transition zone area of for the corporations. So all this this buffer zone are divided in like this, and there is no human are allowed in the core zone. So that is the biosphere reserves. Are being described as a undisturbed natural areas for scientific study, as well as areas in which the condition of disturbance are under control. So that's why nowadays, in place of the national park or the sanctuaries, we are going for the biosphere reserves. So presently, there are 18 notified biosphere reserves in India, and you have seen the list. And they are the Nilgiris, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka, Namdhapa in Arunachal Pradesh, Nanda Devi, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Valley of Flowers, Uttar Pradesh, Andamans and Nicobars, Gulf of Mannar, Tamil Nadu, Kaziranga, Assam, Sundarbans, West Bengal, Thar Desert, Rajasthan, Manas, Assam, Kanha, Madhya Pradesh, Nukrek, and a little line of Kutch, that is Gujarat, and Great Nicobar Islands and Andaman and Nicobar. So these 14 biosphere reserves in India now is under the Indian government, you can see, and the layout of the biosphere, how it is there, the human he is not permitted in the core zone of the biosphere. This is a special project because we are reducing the many species very fastly. So the project Tiger, a fast decline of the tiger population, led to set up of a special task force in 1970, Mandian Board for Wildlife, IBWL. It prepared an action plan to conserve the tiger population in India. As a result, Project Tiger was launched on 1 April 1973. Then another one, the Gear Line project. The Asiatic lines is now confined to a deer forest of Gujarat. The sanctuary harbored only 200 of them. The great reduction in the number was due to increased threat from the overgrazing, depression of prey species, etc. The Asiatic lions was in danger being wiped out either due to the starvation epidemics or human interference in 1972. The state government prepared a scheme for the management of the gear lion sanctuaries with proper guidelines for conservation. The central provided assistance for the protection and improvement of the habitat. तो ये स्पेसिस है जैसे टाइगर बहुत तेजी से कम हो रहे थे, उसके लिए स्पेशल टास्क फोर्स बनाया गया ताकि उनके जो पॉपुलेशन पर चेक किया जाए और जो रिडक्शन हो रहा है उस पर चेक किया जाए। इसी तरह लायंस प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए गिर लाइन प्रोजेक्ट बनाया गया एंड वर्किंग ऑन। सिमिलरली द हिमालयन musk deer project to protect these musk deers. The musk deer, the Muscus muscifera, that is the name, scientific name of that deer, okay, which was once found throughout the Himalayan tract, has terribly suffered due to its musk being used in the preparation of perfumes and medicine. So secondly, the habitat destruction brought about a sharp decline in their population, and the conservation project was therefore launched at the Kedarnath sanctuary in UP. Then crocodile feeding project. The three varieties of crocodile population, there's gharial, the mugger crocodilus, and the saltwater crocodile witnessed a sharp decline by the year 1970s. With the assistance of UNDP, the government of India launched the crocodile breeding and management project. The project on the elephant also, it was launched with the view of protect, conserve the elephant population of the country. Project elephants aim to restoring degraded habitat elephants, creation of migration corridors, elimination of human interference, and establishment of databases for the their migration population dynamic of the elephant. So elephant habitat restoration work was done in Rajaji National Park and conserve the population of the elephants. So this different projects especially to protect or to save the species are carried out by the government of India to preserve the species they are declining and on the verge of extinction. So these in today's lecture we have seen the conservation of biodiversity, and it is very important to conserve, because the ecological cycle, they are very हम लोग ऐसे समझते हैं कि only human beings are responsible for the ecological cycle, but these habitats, they are not directly linked with us, but indirectly they are very important to maintain the ecosystem and the conservation of these different varieties of living organism on the earth is called as biodiversity conservation. Okay, so we learned today the conservation of biodiversity, their objects, various laws made by the Indian governments, their act as per the date we have seen, and the in situ conservation and ex situ conservation. You have seen in-situ conservation is nothing but our national park, biosphere, and sanctuaries. X-ray configuration means the gene bank, the seed bank, and zoological park and the botanical garden. You have the ex-situ conservation of your biodiversity. So thank you for joining for today's lecture. So we will stop here, and if you have any question, you can ask with me. Otherwise, we will. Anything if you have to ask, please.